Hi everybody, this is Scott Sharp with Fretboard Toolbox, and today we're going to look at O Christmas Tree in the key of C major on the baritone ukulele. Let's get started and I'll show you how it works. Today we're going to use a Fretboard Toolbox Holiday Tunes interactive ebook, and we're going to also take a look at the Essential Baritone Ukulele book along with it so we can see where some of those chord notes come from. So we'll start out with just playing the melody. If you already know how to play the melody in the key of C, you can jump ahead. I'll put the time over here on the side. But if you don't, let's take a look at that. And we'll also take a look at the two chords in this song, which is C major, the one chord, and G7, which is the five chord. So if we go to the key of C major page, I want you to be able to see that C majors are always made of the notes C, E, G. So every time we make a C major shape, we're going to be using the notes C, E, and G. And then for G majors, those are made of the notes G, B, and D on every instrument. But we're going to be playing G7, which means we got to add this flat 7 note. 7 or dominant 7 chords are 1, 3, 5 plus a flat 7. 1, 3, 5 is a major, and then flat 7 makes it a dominant 7. So all these notes in white boxes are the major scale notes, and all the melody notes are going to come from the white boxes. So let's get started over here. We're starting out over a C major chord, and we're going to go open 1, 1, 1. So that open is going to be this G note here, and then 1, 1, 1 is C notes. So let's play the first couple measures here. So that's open 1, 1, 1, 3. So open 1, 1, 1, 3, which is D, and then open, open, open are E's. So let's play the first four measures here. So notice how I'm still getting that D note off of my C shape here. Okay, now we're going to the G7 chord, and so for that G7, we need G, B's, and D's plus an F note, and I'll be using a shape where we have just this F added on, and one where we add two Fs. So if I play F, G, B, F, that's still a G7 chord. I just have two Fs in there, but I'm still playing G's, B's, I'm skipping the D, which is fine, but hitting those F notes. Okay, so for that measure here, if we go 3, open 1, okay, so that's 3, which is D, open is E, and then 1 is F, so it looks like this. Okay, and then we go back to 3, 1, which takes us back to the C chord. Okay, so the next four measures are just the same. We can start with this O right here. It's an open fret, and it is where they say, oh, Christmas tree. So, oh, Christmas tree. So, like that. And then we're going to be hitting this G7. Okay, and that's the whole first part of the song. And then the second part is open 2, 2. And this is a dotted one, so we're going to sit on this for a second. It'll sound like this. Or if we started here. And then we're going to hit that G7 when we get to here. Okay? And I'll show you the tab for that in just a sec. So these ones starting here and playing to this sounds like. And then. Starting here, not covered up there. And notice how when we're going back to this C chord here, the melody note goes to the second fret, which is part of our C chord. Okay, so you're going to see the melody notes fit with the chords really beautifully, and that's a key theme in music. So let's play from here to here. Go to that F note, which is going to be part of the G7. Okay, Okay, so you can play along with just the melody, and if you are jumping ahead to the chord part, I still want to show you this, which is if you go to the Fretboard Toolbox website and go to Tracks and Tab, click on Holiday Tunes Volume 1, you get all the backing tracks for the songs for free. So we're listening to Oh Christmas Tree, and you can play it at 100% speed, 85, 70, 55, so you can work your way up to the faster times. But play along with these backing tracks, it's huge, whether you're doing the melody or the melody plus chords. So let's get back to it here. Now we're going to play the more complicated version, which is the melody plus the chords together. So we're going to start here, and the melody notes from this tab up here are the exact same thing, but now we're just going to add some strums in there to be able to kind of accompany ourselves. So let's play these first few measures here. So that's. Okay, we'll do that again slowly. Okay, and just rewind it, play back as many times as you need to, and get it down that way. And we'll start here and go to here. Okay, that took us to right here, and then we're going to start here for the next part. Okay, let's play that slowly, starting here. And then the next part. Okay, let's start here again. And notice how I have to go and flatten my finger, or you could do it with a different finger. However you want to do it, you just need to be able to get these two second frets here right next to each other. So another cool thing you can do with the toolboxes is when you can figure out which notes that you're using, then you can find different places to play it. So this is open, two, two, open. So that's open, G, E, and then, I'm sorry, G, E, A. So it's open, two, two, open. So it's G, E, A, G. Okay, so I can play G, E, A, G up here too, like this. Okay. And then I'm going to play through the whole thing up higher, and I want you to try to figure out how I turned this section right here into playing it up here. And so I'll play it real slow, and then you can try to figure it out on your own. But being able to move things all over the fretboard by figuring out the notes is really, really powerful. So I'm going to play through this section from here to about here, but playing it up higher. So it goes like this. Okay, so that's the exact same thing as. But I'm just playing it up higher. So look around and find different places to play the same things, and you'll build all sorts of good muscle memory too. All right, let's get back to this song here. Once you can play that part, then the whole rest of the song is the parts we've already seen. So that's starting right here. And I'm using my pinky to get this D note here, the third fret, to grab this note. Okay, so it's going to take some time to get that down, but it's really neat when you can start seeing how the melody notes fit in with the chords and why when the song goes to a G7, our melody note hits this F, which is where we've got that really beautiful sound. And you can see that with all sorts of different songs here with the Holiday Tunes book. If you want to pick up your own Holiday Tunes book, you go to the Fretboard Toolbox website and go to Tracks and Tab, go to Holiday Tunes, and then you can order them. I've got tabs for guitar, mandolin, ukulele, baritone ukulele for all five songs. You can order those as ebooks and they'll come to you right away. You can download those immediately. And then if you're interested in looking at the toolboxes further, go to Pick Your Instrument, and I've got books set up just the same for all these different instruments. Today we were using a baritone uke, and we were using the Essential Edition. I've got them in print books and interactive ebooks and standard ebooks. And I've got a complete version that doesn't have the colored circles, but it's got all the keys. If you want to read more about those books, click here. If you want to read more about the different versions you can get, standard ebook, interactive ebook, or print, click here. So anyways, I wish you happy playing, and I appreciate you stopping by, and I'll have lots more videos coming on lots more instruments.